the farm is very different to the Russian trilogy. When I was writing the third book in the trilogy, Agent Six, something happened in my family. My parents had moved to Sweden, a remote village in Sweden, and they were living out there. That was their retirement was going to be there, and they were meant to grow their own vegetables, be very happy. And I thought they were happy. I got a call from my dad one day saying that my mum was suffering from a psychosis. She was ill. She'd been put into a hospital and I needed to fly out to visit them. Now, I was surprised because I didn't have any idea there was anything wrong with my mum. So I booked a ticket to Sweden. But before I could take that flight, my mum called and she'd left the hospital and she said everything my dad had told me was a lie. She wasn't mad. He was involved in a criminal conspiracy and she was coming to London to tell me the truth. So I met her at the airport and we went back to my apartment and she told me this story of what she said had happened in Sweden, which was terrible things my dad had done. And I had to decide whether to believe my dad or my mum. So that's the premise for the book, and the reason it's such a dramatic change is partly because the story is clearly not set in Russia, it's set in England and Sweden, and it's set in the modern day. I mean, the challenge of writing about a world that is different to your own is you have to try and make it personal. So you have to try and put yourself in a situation which is far away from you. When you write about things close to you, I think you have to try and take the outside world and put it in. You have to make it relevant to everyone else. So it's a very different challenge, but I wouldn't say one was easier or harder than the other. The central question is how well we know each other. And that can be a very daunting question, because when you have secrets, they can be very destructive. But I think it's also part of the challenge. It can be a positive thing, which is trying to get to know someone, trying to overcome that gap between us is why we learn how to speak, it's why we learn how to write. It's about trying to get over those gaps that we do some of our most amazing and inspiring things. So those gaps can be very destructive, but I think they can also be a sort of source of creation. And so that's the sort of two sides to those elements.